Hi, I'm Josh Berk. I'm the Executive Director here at the Bethlehem Area Public Library. First of all, as we come out of this, you know, pandemic year, we just want to let people know that we're here and we're open and we're back in business. Libraries, like most places, were pretty well locked down for the past year, and unlike anything we've ever been through. And you know, now we're just beginning to really welcome people back in. The summer is always a busy and exciting time at the library. There's a lot of interesting learning activities for kids, reading programs for adults, and all sorts of you know, interesting events and things you can take advantage of at the library. So that's the first thing. Just know that we're here and we're ready for we're open for business and we're happy to see people again. Well, the big thrust of the library summer reading program is really just to keep kids reading over the summer months. As maybe some of you have heard, there's always a sort of regression, they call it the summer slide, when kids are out of school and they maybe lose some reading fluency, and you know, it's just important to practice that skill every day. So libraries all over the country, all over the world, have these summer programs where the main thing is you check out books, you read them, you get prizes. So we reward you for reading books. So that's the main thrust of the summer program. And you know, that's to, you know, encourage kids to keep reading. It's so important for their academic success and future success in life. And then we also like to have fun. So we have all sorts of different events. We have a magician every year. That's always a big hit. We have live animals come in from some conservancy groups. They bring in, you know, every time we bring in animals to the library, that's like a big hit. And like my favorite program probably is there's a literacy program with therapy dogs, where the dog owners come in and bring the dogs in, and kids practice their reading. And the dogs just sit there and listen, but it's the cutest thing you've ever seen, and that's always like my favorite day at the library when all the pups are here. So our library in particular has some unusual outside of the box things, I think, that libraries don't always have. We have a bike share program. You can borrow a bike from the front desk and ride through the city of Bethlehem or down through the trails we have nearby. We have a recording studio in the basement of the main library. You can come in and record a podcast or record an album or whatever it is you're working on down there. That's all free to use. We have been working hard to provide internet access to those in our community who might not have access to it. So we have a ton of computers for people to use. We also have internet hotspots you can borrow and take home. If you need that service, you can take advantage of that here at the library. So yeah, we have a couple of things you might not expect, and as well, of course, you know, a wonderful collection of books for readers of all ages. I think libraries are one of the few remaining places where everyone can come, regardless of income level, age, background, housing status, anything of that sort. It's one of the very few places that doesn't ask you to spend any money while you're here. So everything the library offers just about is free. So you know, there's a shrinking number of places in contemporary society where everyone can get together and be on equal footing, and the library is one of those. Prior to the pandemic, and hopefully again soon, the library rents out a lot of meeting rooms. There's a lot of groups. There's just that real need for people to have a public meeting space, a community space. So whether it's like a city forum, or it's a, you know, private group of collectors, or study groups, or, you know, the library really brings groups of people together in a safe and communal space.